I'm your host, Brian Makse, racing driver, lover of driving fast, fun things. And on this channel, you get reviews for drivers from drivers. Now, the question is whether Mini can transform the Cooper into a pure electric, and will it still remain fun? That is the basic question here, because the Minis are all fun in one way or another. They're fun in terms of their aesthetic, they're fun in the way they drive, but transforming a Cooper into a pure electric is a fundamental change. It really changes a lot of things with respect to the Cooper, and it changes the dynamics, as we will get into. So let's have a look at this in a little more depth. Doesn't matter what kind of car we're driving, what matters is how you interface with it as a driver, and this is pretty much like any other Mini Cooper. We recently drove the convertible, we drove the five-door, and aesthetically and ergonomically inside, it is fundamentally the same. There's the little digital instrument cluster and the big screen here, and the quirky secondary and tertiary ergonomics, but otherwise I'm set up perfectly as a driver here. I'm very comfortable behind the wheel, lots of adjustment in the seat and the steering wheel, and I'm just set up perfectly, interfacing with the car perfectly. And the rest of the ergonomics, well, they're just as quirky as every other Mini, but once you get used to it, you're gonna be very happy with it, because it's always a delight to be behind the wheel of a Mini. One of the things I do love, other than the quiet ride, is this seat. It is very comfortable, very supportive. I feel like I can go on a very long road trip with this, and certainly I would be very comfortable on a longer road trip than the battery range is capable of delivering, as we will get into shortly. In terms of spaciousness, it is a modern Mini, so in the front row anyway, you've got lots of room. In the back, well, that's best used for storage, and under the hatch, well, I've got my camera bag and a backpack, and that is all that's going to fit under the hatch. The infotainment system is a riff on BMW's iDrive, so that means it's very sophisticated. Does have wireless Apple CarPlay. Have no idea whether it's got Android Auto, and we really don't care on this channel now, do we? Given that this is an EV, acceleration is instantaneous, and 0 to 60 happens in about 7 seconds, so it's very quick getting up to speed on the highway, no problem at all, and it cruises along at highway speeds, no problem. The biggest difference, of course, is how this rides, and it is a little quieter because there is no internal combustion engine, so you do hear a little bit more wind noise, maybe a little bit more road noise than you would in a regular Mini Cooper S. The electric motor makes 184 horsepower and 270 pounds of torque, and that torque is available all the time, of course. The other consideration is I think this weighs 3,900 pounds, so it's not a lightweight, it's not a Mini in that regard, but the instant torque of the electric motor makes up for it, that's for sure. I'd love to know a little bit more about how the electric motor works in this front-wheel drive application, but technical specification seems to be hidden from normal view, but I'm sure someone out there knows how this works. How it works from behind the wheel, however, is you do get a little bit of torque steer when you're aggressive with the throttle. Otherwise, this tracks straight and true, and acceleration, of course, is the name of the game here. It's just flawless, and of course, it's silent as well, which is a nice treat. Normally, we talk about transmission function at this point and the quality of it, but there is no transmission because it's an EV. What that means is you just throw it into drive. There is a sport mode, which gives you a little bit more aggressive throttle mapping, which is fun, and that's how I'm driving this. It's certainly easier to drive in sport mode and accelerate a little quicker, and that is fun. But the regenerative braking function is pretty aggressive. It's still not quite a one-pedal driving operation, but it doesn't work too badly. You just have to recalibrate your brain and the way it works. In terms of advanced driver assist, it's got rudimentary lane keep, and it does not have adaptive cruise. And you'd think with a tech forward car like this, it should have adaptive cruise, but alas, this one does not. Like I mentioned earlier, it does have a couple of drive modes. I think there is eco, well, there's green and green plus, not eco. There's a mid, which is the standard mode, and sport, which we're driving in all the time just because it adds a little more liveliness to the whole driving experience. Of course, what we're always interested in is braking, and they seem to have done a decent job with respect to blending the regenerative function with that transition to actual braking with the physical brakes themselves, and it works pretty well, but that regenerative function kind of dominates the overall experience. In terms of handling, it's still very much a mini, which means it is still fun to drive, despite the weight penalty of the batteries and all of the EV systems. This is a heavy mini, mind you, but it's still fun to drive. And what they have done is calibrated the suspension so that it is very comfortable and still handles well. It might ride a little bit better than the regular Cooper S in that they've got to go with heavier spring rates and they've changed the damping rates as well. Ride quality is excellent with this mini EV. In terms of its dynamic package, it's certainly helped by the fact that weight is very low in this car. The majority of the weight sits fairly low, and it doesn't seem to have the balance of a typical front-wheel drive car. It's a little more neutral in that regard, but when you're hustling through corners, it's great that the weight is very low in this car. That helps a little bit. There's not a lot of body roll, but the way the suspension is calibrated certainly helps, and they've done a fine job tuning this for the additional weight of the batteries and the electric motor. The overall driving experience is dominated by the fact that it's a quiet driving experience. These tires are relatively quiet. The only thing you really hear, at least at highway speeds, is a little bit of wind noise, but it's very quiet in here. My verdict? Well, what we've got here is a city electric car, which works for a lot of people. Reason being, it's got a 114 mile range or 180 kilometers worth of range. And, you know, that's not bad for a city car. It doesn't work if you've got longer distance to travel, especially here in Canada, where the big cities or the destinations from those cities are of greater distances. For example, the drive I went on yesterday was, I think, 200 kilometers each way. That would not have worked very well for this car, given that there wasn't a charger at my destination. But, you know, when you've got a car like this, this works great in the city. Hopefully you've got another car that has a greater range, or you've got a car with an internal combustion engine and you can fuel up quite easily. But that's not what we're talking about here. What we're talking about is this mini electric and whether it's fun to drive. And absolutely it is, as long as you're buying this with the understanding that it is more of a city electric car, then it works great. And it also works great because the dimensions are smaller than most compact cars, so it fits everywhere. It works wonderfully as a city car. It works great in that regard, and for that reason I think this is still a heck of a lot of fun to drive. And I kind of like this mini as an EV. It's a blast to drive. Given this use case, this limited use case being a city electric, you've got to take price into consideration. On the other hand, don't forget that minis are still very premium, and this feels very, very well screwed together. All the materials are very premium, but you're going to pay for it. Starts in the low 30s in the US, starts in the low 40s in Canada, and then this one is fully equipped, so it's in the upper 30s in the US and upper 40s in Canada before any incentives. And there are, of course, EV incentives all over the place. Check your local regulations to be certain, but it is a special kind of car in that it is a very premium city electric car. I don't think they're going to sell millions of these, but it's still a blast to drive, and I really enjoy it. If I needed a city electric, I would definitely be looking at one of these because it's so much fun, and it's certainly more interesting than some of the smaller EVs in the market today. Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this Mini Cooper SE, or Mini's electric vehicle. Hope you liked this piece, and if you did, well, you're not new to YouTube, you know what to do. Smash the subscribe button, turn on your notifications, like this video, and as always, sharing is caring. So please share this with your friends, especially on Reddit, because on Reddit they really need to see reviews for drivers from drivers. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. If you want to support the channel, please hit up our merch store. Links here, links below. Lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our very popular line of Save the Manuals merch, and thankfully Mini still makes manuals. Nice job. Anyway, thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time, and remember, cars don't understeer by themselves, not even Mini electrics. Oh, that's an automatic car with a fart can exhaust. You know, that's not going to sound great. Maybe a little nauseating.